Paul, assessment of that game?
Really good game. Feels pretty disappointing to lose 2 points in the last 30 seconds, but generally really pleased with how we approached the game today. And I suppose at the end of the season we'll look back and say it was a good point, or be it we came very close to the three.
Yeah, I suppose it does feel a little bit like a defeat in a way at the moment, doesn't it? Because you were so close to taking all three.
Yeah, it feels disappointing. You're that close, and you know, it ended with a very long ball in the box, and we probably had too many players going for it. I think there was so much desire to keep the ball out of our box. We I think too many players went for the header, and it landed, and the guy whacked it in. So I suppose at 1-0, that is always a possibility. You've always got, you know, there's always, you could, no matter what you do, one long ball in the box, one set piece, one free kick, you've always got a chance of conceding. So I suppose the only disappointment we've had is that we didn't manage to score second in that probably 20-25 minutes after half time.
It was a spell, of course, and the bar was hit. That was the opportunity. You feel as if a second would have killed this game off.
Yeah, I mean, I think we had numerous breaks through their midfield and you know, into their back line, and we just either didn't pick the right pass or we didn't do something that just created the goal. We came very, very close two or three times. So it's hard to pick fault, really, because we tried so hard. We came very close to the 3 points. There's very little to, in isolation, to pick on and say it's no one's fault. There's no one individually. If I could be cross with someone, I would. I don't think there's anyone I could find.
I suppose it's such as that clear.
I don't want to be cross with. It's just what it is. You know, we tried really hard. It's football. We got a point against a good team. March on.
Clinicality in the final third, then that's basically what you're saying, isn't it? Scoring those goals in the final.
Yeah, and on other days you score three, and I'm not digging too deep. You know, we came very close there, just didn't quite get. I mean, I think the only thing I was disappointed with, I think we didn't quite execute our set pieces well enough. I mean, I think we had numerous that we delivered poorly. We missed an opportunity maybe to get a second for a set piece. So if I'm picking on something, if you'd like me to, that would be it. Other than that, I love the way we went about it, the players' effort. And as a manager, you know, you get to that, these sort of games, 1-0 up away from home, and it's 20 minutes to go, and you look at your bench and you look at players on the pitch who are getting tired, and then it's 15, then it's 10. Sometimes you just think, well, they just got to guts it out, because if I make a change, I might put fresh legs on, but something's going to change. The dynamic's going to change. And, you know, so Robbie Simpson, you know, tiring, but every time there was a corner, he seemed to be the one heading out of the box. And you think, you know, sometimes you just play that card as a manager. These 11 have got to see it out, and they came so close.
It's interesting because you've answered the question. Next question, you know, it's so rare these days, I guess, to see a game for 90 minutes with just 11 players and no substitutes. I mean, was there Tuesday in mind? Was there anything that in your head?
No, nothing. We discussed it every minute for about half an hour, and you keep coming back to it. If you're not sure, do nothing. And that's really what it came down to. You know, you can't. We were solid. They had some pressure. We had a chance to break away, and there was nothing obvious. There was tired legs, but they were doing the right things. You know, and it's okay. They scored a goal with 30 seconds to go, and you think, well, maybe I could have done something then, but in that moment, you know, if you're not sure, sometimes those players are just, and that'll happen every now and then. Those players have just got to say, all right, take a deep breath, and they've got to guts it out, and they came so close to it.
Still unbeaten in the league?
Still unbeaten, yeah. Yeah, on to the next, march on.
Just finally on Chucks and EK's now an MK Dons player until January. He's got the opportunity to prove himself and be back in the squad, I take it?
Yeah, absolutely. Yeah, he's back in training Monday, and, you know, but he'll go into the mix with all the other players, and he'll have to, you know, focus on what he's got in front of him, which is at least 4 months now with us into the next window. But lots of things can happen in 4 months. So I've arrived at the club within a transfer window. Now that window is closed, and there's a lot that can happen between now and January. So I'm not going to shut any doors. I'm not going to make any promises. And I'm philosophical about what all the players can give the team, and we've got a lot of players to choose from now, so we'll see.
Robbie Muirhead also left the club. Any word on that?
Yeah, Robbie's moved back to Scotland, and he's one of the players. When I arrived, there was discussions whether he was going to stay or not. I have to say, I would have wondered whether there were more than just a player or two that have left over the last couple of months, but it's Robbie's gone, and we've got a lot of players, and it's the start of a transition process. I'm happy what the team's done so far, and I'm probably going to start talking about the players who are here now, and what's about to happen next.
Another massive defensive performance as well, I thought.
Yeah, it was. I mean, we came, you know, what if, but I thought they did really well, and they showed a lot of gall and a lot of desire to defend. And I think they're probably the only, you know, you're going to get a team that puts the ball in the box no matter what happens during the first 80 minutes of the game. It's only 1-0, you're going to get something at you. Just a real shame. I don't think Lee had to make too many saves today, meaningful saves, so it was a shame. I just think too many players probably going for the ball. but anyway, it can happen, and you know, we have to look at the game overall. I think we played really well.
See, on the flip side of that, their keeper was far more busy, wasn't he?
Made some good saves. He made some really good saves. Yeah, yeah. But I mean, we're entitled to try to score. They're entitled to try and score, and it comes down to score more than the opposition. Today it was a draw.
And there was a variety of different people testing the goalkeeper as well, which must have pleased you.
Yeah, we had the midfield players involved, and you could see Bailey Cargo getting forward, and you know, when we got a chance to attack, they've got. There's nothing holding them back, and I think we'll gain again some more confidence from today. It doesn't feel like it at the moment, but we will.